for Stick of Dynamite goes by the name of Young Prodigies, and they do hip-hop slash R&B out of Glenville, Georgia.
Georgia.
We started our duo in February 27, 2010, and we consist...
Is that actually
them? Yeah. Yeah, yeah. And we consist of me, Pittman, and T. Wiley. One day, we was just hanging out. We was just hanging out, and I discovered T. Wiley could sing and rap. We both had always loved music.
Wait, are these rappers wearing...
Hollister.
Yeah, wearing Hollister?
Yeah, they're wearing Hollister. They're wearing Hollister.
That's some gangsta ass
That's
motherfuckers.
That's gangsta. We talked about doing something with it. So we just decided to just go ahead and start making acoustic slash hip hop slash R&B music.
All
right. We currently have two mixtapes. The first being Lost Prayers, and our most recently released one, The Comeback. And we are currently working on third mixtape, Forgotten Farewells. All right. And this is Young Prodigies with their song, Far and Away, featuring Jizzle.
Not from the beginning, from the first time I saw you, I just knew that there was something so special about you. You had that cute figure, pretty face. You had me locked all up, and you had me stuck up in the daze. Yeah, girl, there was so much that I could tell you. All of my friends think I'm crazy, they say I'm a fool. But what they say don't faze me one little bit, cause to me, all they hear is straight bullshit. Cause as long as I got you in my life, I'll always strive better. I'll never hurt you like a knife. Never gonna do anything that's wrong. I'll stay up late hours on the phone with you walking around as my number one girl. I won't settle till I give you the whole wide world. Cause it's not the same without you in it. This is verse one that I've just finished.
I understand why you cannot stay.
Understand, girl.
But why do you got to be so far away?
Why you gotta be?
Cause I understand why you cannot stay.
Understand, girl.
But why do you got to be so far away today?
Baby, I see you almost every day, but since you got a man, it seems that you're so far away. And yeah, I know that I wasn't one of the best, but could you please replace the heart that you ripped out of my chest? Since we first talked, everything seemed to click, and you was having problems with the other dude you was with. Then I came around and swept you right off your feet, and magically somehow you were on my team, and you was the only one. Yeah, you was my captain, and I look back on the past, I'm like, damn, what happened? It started off as a dream, but ended up as a nightmare. So I guess these are the reasons why I'm sitting right here, writing this song, trying to stay strong, trying to move on. But until then, I'm all alone. And girl, I see you almost every day, but since you got a man, it seems that you're so far away.
Cause I understand why you cannot stay.
Understand, girl.
Why do you?
All right, that was Young Prodigies, Far and Away, featuring Jizzle. And if you want to contact them, you can contact their manager, Andrew Pittman, at andrewpittman563@hotmail.com. You can also check them out on MySpace, Young Prodigy Music, and you can find them on YouTube, Young Prodigies 1. And that's Prodigies with an S, by the way.
Like it matters.
Yeah, well, they spelled it wrong, but that's okay.
That's all right.
Do work.
I've never written so much shit in my entire life. I'm gonna say this. I like that you are trying stuff. You know, you're putting the guitar. It didn't really work for me because your song wasn't executed very well. But I like that you're trying stuff. That's good at least. The intro, I'm like, okay, this is all right. And then I was like, what the fuck? And you just like the rapping came in, and you are way too close to the mic. Your levels are way off. The production is so awful. I'm sorry. Like, I'm not an engineer by any means, and if I can hear how bad the production level is, it's bad, to be honest with you. And as far as the first verse, you know, I like that you had a message. You were trying to say something. You know, you're like, it sounded like you were kind of speaking from the heart. That's cool, but you need to finish your words. Your cadence was awful. You kept falling off. Like, you couldn't ride the beat at all. And to be honest, you didn't even have a good voice for rapping. You know, it you would have to come out with some like sterling, sparkling, beautiful shit with that voice for me to dig it. And come in, I'm sorry, come in with that voice and just the way the song was put together, I was already not a buyer on this. The hook, I think, was a good idea. Bad singing and bad rapping. Yeah. You know? I think your whole idea for the song was really not a bad idea at all. I just think if, you know, if you had a good recording and, you know, you were better at rapping and the singer was better at singing, I think you guys just have a ton of work to do, you know, and I hope people around you aren't telling you that you're hot. I really hope that they're not. I hope they're being honest with you because, I'm not saying that you guys are talentless, you know, but definitely you guys have a lot of work to do. And the second verse was better. You kept a slower cadence and you were able to actually, like, you enunciated, you finished your words real slow, simple, and fuck, go with your strengths, I guess. You know what I mean? It sounded better than the first verse, but that's, to be honest, that's really not saying much. This whole song to me, honestly, was just, I'm sorry, it was absolutely awful. There was nothing I liked about the song. You know what I mean? Because nothing was executed well. There wasn't one part of this song that I said, well, they did a good job on that. There's really not one part of this song that I thought that they did a good job on, to be honest with you guys. So just keep working and hopefully you guys get better. You know what I mean? I don't want you guys to fail. But if you keep this shit up, you will. You know what I mean? So please, please get better. And if you guys get better, send us more shit. We'll listen to it. We'll be on the show. But, I mean, fuck, we'll listen to it. Unless it's season 3, we'll let you back on. But, you know, just please, please, like, I'm not trying to be an asshole. Like, I'm being serious, you know what I mean? And that's pretty much where I'm at. Hoff?
You know, I'm going to just elaborate on what Jay said. There was something I did find really good about the song.
The ending?
The beat. That beat was solid. I'm not even going to lie. As a musician, it was solid.
He chose a good beat.
Yeah, that beat was solid. It really was.
See, that's how we know you're a real musician. All I heard was shit, and you were able to pick a diamond out of that. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that was honestly a solid beat. That really
was. Very good, very good.
But I will say that, like how you said, like they're trying something new. It's not really new. This style has been done before, but it's obviously been done a lot better.
I don't hear too much, like with a guitar at the beginning. And
oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Like artists.
I didn't think it was a rap song at first when I first heard the...
No, yeah, that's what I'm saying. It doesn't sound like a rap song at all.
Yeah, like now there is a real transition in that kind of style because a lot of hip-hop artists are picking up a lot of indie influences. Yep. Yeah. So you have people like Kid Cudi and Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
If you listen to their albums, they're really like this. They're like acoustic guitar. They're all bands. They play with live bands.
Yeah.
So it's,
and then they
it's,
get the rap on.
Yeah, that's exactly what they do. So this, I mean, it's a good mainstream style, but it needs work. Like definitely the rapping, and let's pick it apart. Okay. All
right.
The rapping, you definitely need to work on that. You need to listen to more than mainstream hip hop to get your style down. Because if you listen to other like older artists, you will understand how you will get a better feel like how to put your words together better.
I don't know if I 100% agree with them getting there. I think they can listen to try to, like you said, as far
no, it's
as
just getting, the influences.
But the thing is, though, I just don't.
I think they need a metronome so they can get timing down.
Yeah, timing will help.
Yeah, yeah, timing
was bad. But they're white guys. But
that's true. That's true. I picture him doing like the Carlton dance when they're.
Yeah. I was doing that the beginning of the show.
Yeah,
right, so,
yeah, that was hot. See.
Yeah. See. So, but. Yeah, you need to work on your rapping. You need to work on your timing, and your homeboy can't sing. Definitely. Yeah. So
that wasn't hot at all.
If you get a better producer, like, well, it sounded like they recorded themselves. So I'm not gonna hate on that too much because it's hard to record.
I'm
by
amazed
yourself.
That they have a manager.
It's
probably little brother or something.
That's what I'm thinking. It's Uncle Pete. Yeah. Hey, Uncle Pete, you want to manage us? Sure. Let me put down
this is
these.
What I gotta do.
Yeah, let me finish this 12-pack of Busch Lights. I'll be right there.
I got an email.
They drink PBR over there, okay?
Booyah. It's actually a good beer.
Yeah, I don't mind it, actually. No, it's pretty good and it's cheap.
Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah, like, just work on your timing, work on your rapping. Like, definitely work on your rapping if you want to keep doing this. Find a better guy that can sing. If you want to go out alone, I would say go out alone. If you're making the beats, then go it alone. Just make beats, because that was a good beat.
Make beats for people. There you go.
No, I mean, there's serious money in that.
No, yeah, for sure.
I don't think they made the beat. I think they chose the beat.
Oh.
I mean, you could,
because they had the
mixtape beat?
It had I don't know if it's a mixtape, but it had the watermark at the beginning.
Oh yeah, that's right. Oh. That's right. Huh? Yeah. That is
well, then
right.
Good selection on the beat.
Yeah. Well, then how about this? How about you guys are cheaters?
Cheaters. Stone Cold Cheaters.
You know what? But that was a solid beat. Whoever that was, kudos. That was a good beat. Another thing that I would recommend is get the fuck off of MySpace, because no one's on it anymore, and get on Facebook.
Yeah.
Or YouTube.
Yeah.
Facebook or YouTube.
They're on YouTube.
Well, they're on. Yeah. Yeah. Get off of MySpace, because no one is fucking on
that
anywhere.
They're not on the face.
Else.
They're not on the
not
face.
Not even artists?
Well, no, they're
not
on the
face.
No,
I know.
Yeah.
The messages we have is...
my face.
We're going to Facebook soon.
Yeah, everything is dead on MySpace. Get off of MySpace.
Yeah.
So like I say, I'm going to turn it over to...
Do it.
Okay.
I like that. Taking my job. I like that.
Yeah, I agree with Diesel. I agree with Diesel with everything, basically. There was something that...
Can I say something?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, overall, the song sucked. Okay.
So what's your rating? Did we get the rating?
No, that's after.
Oh, all right.
What did you say was good?
The beat.
The beat?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I agree with the Hoff.
Simple.
Well, everything with the Hoff said, I agreed with.
And everything that D said.
Yeah, but yours more than Hoff. Hoff went into elaboration of influences.
We're not that smart.
Well, it's just like... You just need to get...
But he's a musician.
You got to get the fundamentals down first before you can go start getting influences. You know, you got to learn how to write the beat. You have to... the recording, I don't blame you. You probably did it from home and stuff, but...
No, but that was a bad recording.
It was really bad.
That wasn't even close to being good.
The second verse was actually a little better than...
Second was better, yeah.
Than the first one,
but
so...
I give that credit to the rapper himself, because he actually was on time, where the first guy was just all over
the
place.
Yeah, the second guy wrote... I mean...
The second guy was a little better.
He wrote the beat. It was simple as shit.
Yeah.
At least he wrote the beat, though.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, the first guy was all over the place. Yeah. And that's why I didn't know if I thought that he should go listen to all these guys and try to...
Yeah, yeah.
Because I'm like, don't... Because then it seems like that's how people start copying people.
Yeah, yeah.
And they start... When you don't have your style yet and you start trying to get influences from anybody, then I think you're going to try to be like that person.
Yeah, exactly.
And don't try to be like that person. You know what I mean? Be like you. I think there's nothing wrong with listening and maybe trying to get like little tips, like you said.
Uh-huh.
But I think if you're... Because the first guy sounded so inexperienced that... I think you just need to just go back to the lab, just find what your sound is, find your cadence, find what feels good to you, and then, you know what I mean, kind of see what else. Listen, I'm sure you already listen to music anyway, but just as long as you're not trying to be like anybody, as long as you only try to be you, you know what I mean? Well, right now you ain't working, but you is not working for you right now, but you just need to go and find what your sound is. And I don't feel like either one of them has a sound, because they're both so generic. Mm-hmm. Because it's not like neither one of them have like a too short platinum sound. So you don't have a sound that's good, and you don't have a style that's good. So it's almost like we don't even know who you are. Like you don't have, like, lyrically and all that stuff. As far as the MC, I wouldn't even say MC. As far as rapper goes, I just don't think you know who you are. You have an identity, is what it sounds like to me.
I will agree with that 100%.
But are you good?
Just another thing. The guy on the hook. He can't sing. I'm just gonna say he can't sing. But I did like what you guys were going for on the hook. So, props to that.
That's what I'm saying. I think the hook would have been good if it executed correctly.
If it executed correctly, it
was a good try.
It would have been really good. That's it. That's all I got.
Fair enough, Death Man.
All right. Pretty much what you guys said. Production value was really bad. I mean, I know I understand you guys probably doing it yourself. But you know, the guy had to step away about 3 or 4 feet from the mic, because that guy was like on top of it or something.
He was like this.
And I take the lady to the club. That tower goes and a rubber dub dub.
The guy was deep throwing the mic.
There
or
you
something.
Go, platinum hit, according to you guys.
There was that, and I was like, man, just take a step away from the mic or something.
Maybe he swallowed the mic while he was recording, exactly. And he just kept going, so it was down his throat, maybe.
And I thought, you know,
not his fault. Not his fault at all.
The first guy was very monotone. You know, just monotone, just straight.
That's true.
Just
true.
Very monotone.
That's a good point.
And yeah. I was just like, you know what? The other second guy actually, you know, he actually had that verse where he pitched it up a little bit higher, where where this guy was just like, blah, 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 blah.
That happens when you read your lyrics.
Anyone. You know, it's just like.
That's when you could tell someone's reading the lyrics.
And then, he probably was reading it because that's probably what threw off his timing because he had really bad timing. The hook was off key. It was a good hook, but it was off key as shit.
Yeah.
Second verse was a lot better, but it's not saying much because he was average at best.
You're comparing it to the first verse. That's why.
Yeah, that's why. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I mean, the second guy was a lot better. I don't know who the intro said that he was a great singer. I didn't hear it. Maybe he has better songs. Or, I don't know, maybe auto-tuned the hook or something because it was off-key.
Yeah, that's sad. Like,
I wonder if it could fix it.
Begging for
auto-tune. They could probably fix it.
Like, in a studio, anybody could be fixed. Anybody.
Yes,
they could probably fix it because...
Hey, I sang, so...
That's true. It was beautiful.
That's about it. I mean, off-key on the singing, and that's about it.
All right, we beat him up. We beat him up enough.
Yeah. It's overall gay.
Yeah, it's awful. Honestly, I'm never gonna listen to it again, Hoff.
I will never listen to it again.
Oh,
ditto.
And Another Man.
Never listen to it again.
Well, there it is. Obviously, you know, our vote is never listen to it again. But everything we said it is meant to be constructive. So please.
So what did you think? Leave a comment down below and tell the artist what you thought.